100 episodes, folks. We did it. 100 episodes. What an accomplishment. But you're not here to listen to me ramble. You're here for the interview, of course. Before I get there, I have a few things we need to go through. She requested to not go through the content, so I've only got four pieces, just an announcement and three pieces of art. We get through that, and the interview will begin. So don't, for those of you who are scared and thinking, where's Ms. Heed? She'll be here. I promise you that. The big announcement that I want to say is Cinemaquestria is now going to be looking for volunteers. We're opening up our third wave of recruiting volunteers. We've only begun with the preliminaries on it, so we haven't worked the details out. However, if you think you would be interested in joining us here at Cinemaquestria and making this place a better place, stick around. We'll have all the information on the website. I'll be throwing information in BwB here in future episodes. Just stay tuned. The details will follow. What I did want to say was just that we are looking to now bring on new volunteers. The other three pieces of art, let's get to them. Let's get them out of the way. Oh, and for the poops and giggles here. Good water. This one I saw, much like with a lot of you guys, probably much earlier in the week. But this is one of those that I had to put on there. This is Sonata Plush Plushie with Taco, Socks, and Hoodie by Buttercup Baby PPG. Powerpuff Girl. Not only is this just an amazing piece of... just an amazing looking plushie. One of the reasons why I wanted to show it is because it's poseable. I'll read the description here. The commissioner requested I turn her, Sonata, into a unicorn, as I originally made her an earth pony. She's 14 inches tall from hoof to the top of the head, has a rotatable head, and comes with removable hoodie, socks, necklace, and tacos. Well, taco, single. This wasn't much of a brainer, folks. The fact that it's not only poseable, but just a darn good-looking plushie was one of those, I've got to put it on here. This wasn't a contest. To me, I think what gets me are the accessories. Sure, she can look great as is, but to have the accessories come with it, especially the taco, I think was really well done and is very cute. Now go comment and tell her how amazing this looks. All right, next one on the list. This one is titled Horsey Ride by DM29. One of the reasons I wanted to put this one on was it's just downright cute. I can only imagine that Discord has something to do with this. And Spike is just saying, well, might as well take advantage of the situation. Rainbow Dash's best pony. I like that. Shoot, that was my last quarter. Matt. No, as in, he was the one who basically set this whole thing up. There's that. All right. And last, I did decide to include a comic, so y'all get to hear my terrible voice acting. So as when Ms. Heed comes on, you can go, wow, she is so much better than him. This is The Secret Life of Fleur Disley, number 7, by Lovely Neckbeard. Number 8's already been released, and yes, we will be reading it. I know you, and I know all your moves, so I won't give it up.
Oh, really? Then you must remember that we can fly.
Foof. Shrek. Ah! Crash.
You always stuck to the rules, even if it put you at a disadvantage. How pathetic.
Stick around next week, folks, as we do part 8. But in the meantime, this is The Secret Life of Fleur Disley, number 7, by Lovely Neckbeard. Yeah, I was trying to get Fleur's voice down before the show, so... Hey, Tim, that was a... To me, that just falls under, why not? Why would I not give her a terrible German accent? All right. Now it is the creme de la creme. Hello, Ms. Heed.
Hello.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Excellent. Then shall we begin?
Yes.
For the record, please state your name that you wish to be addressed by. I'm starting with what I always like to call my first 5 questions.
Okay.
So please state for the record the name you wish for all of us to address you by. Your job in regards to the pony fandom. So you're an artist, you're a video maker, etc., etc. What else? Your favorite episode from Friendship is Magic, if you have one, of course, and you can go by seasons.
Uh-huh.
And your favorite character from Generation 4 specifically, and if applicable... Yeah, don't worry, I'll be repeating
that. Was
that.
A lot of...
Don't worry, it's the last one. As I always said, it's the first 5.
Oh, well. First of all, I have to say hi to the chat room. Hi. I can see your... Oh, woo, Anneli. Shai Kumo says. And then Len Her says, Anneli.
I see you are watching it. Perfect.
Yeah. So the first question, I'm Anneli Heed, and I'm a Swedish voice actress, and... I do voices on a lot of cartoons, such as My Little Pony, Friendship is Magic, and I voice, I voice Spike, and Cadance, and Chrysalis, and Spitfire, and a lot of other ponies on that show.
So tell me more about who your favorite character is on the show.
It's so hard to choose. I really like Spike because he's just Spike-alicious. So I really like him. But then, of course, I like Spitfire because, she's the reason why I'm here. So I like her. And, of course, Cadence because she's a pink princess with wings. I mean, wow.
And then, of course, she's shown that she can duke it out just like the best of them.
Mm. Oh, yeah. And, of course, Chrysalis' best villain.
Can you give us a line in Chrysalis' voice then?
Which line?
Ooh, tough one. How about, well, you pick. I mean, you can always pick one.
I can't remember, and I just know it in Swedish, so. She says something like she's going to take over Equestria, so it's like something. Yeah, it's not going to sound the same as in Swedish, of course, but something like, and then I'm going to take over all Equestria! And then it's just a...
Perfect.
Thank you.
My pleasure. It's all on this side, believe me.
And then I see Cadence here. It's like, she's like here, like very royal and princessy. So just kind of, you know, with this kind of concerned voice, like, no, we have to save everyone. Oh, no. Like that, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
You have to save everyone. Oh, no.
You save the world.
Save the world.
Tell me more about your favorite episodes.
There's a lot of them. I really like when Spike gets greedy and mad. Mm-hmm. That's fun because I can relate. it's fun to be him when he's doing his thing. And then, I like. Ooh, all of the season finales has been really good. I mean, the season finale of season 2 was really nice with the... So I got to sing This Day Aria. I had fun with it, so that was nice. I think that's my favorite 2 episodes, actually, yeah.
I was gonna, what makes This Day Aria such a great song to sing?
It just, you know, it has it all. The intrigues, the drama, the, you know... Good versus evil, and I got to sing them both, so it's like, ah! Kind of a Gollum moment there.
Speaking of which, does that happen often enough in not just your voice acting, but I'll say real life for that
Where
matter.
Are you going with this? No. Yeah, it's yeah, actually, every day when I want candy. Like, oh, I really want this candy. No, I shouldn't, you know, really. No, but I need this candy now. No. I had this conversation with me, in my head, of course. Otherwise, it would be weird. So weird.
Do all your characters' voices live in your head, as in really live in your head?
Maybe. Well, let's just say that I have... when I started to voice act, I bought all of the characters that I could get my hands on. So I have a shelf full of characters that I voiced and, you know, dolls and stuff. It has happened, yes. I have. You know, when I hold them, it's like, okay, playtime. And my daughter loves it. She's 4 years old, so she's like, oh, mommy, come on. Let's play more with the dolls.
So is it safe to say you've never grown up?
Yes, that's very safe to say. And I'm not intending to growing up. You know, I'm never going to do that. Sounds boring to grow up.
I was going to say it sounds boring.
Yeah.
So why don't we take a bit of a different turn here, and I'll get a little bit more serious. Oh, don't worry. It's going to... You know, I don't know where I was going with that. But let's start at the beginning.
Yes.
What inspired you to get started in voice acting?
I saw Little Mermaid when I was a kid, and I totally fell in love with it. And I was like, ooh, I would love to do voices too, because I was already impersonating all of my teachers and my friends. And sometimes it was not good to impersonate your teacher, let me tell you. I got the attention, yes. I really wanted to do that. So I actually asked my parents, oh, I need to make voices for cartoons. They said, well, you're just a kid and we don't live in Stockholm. And, you know, it's really far away to the studios. So they didn't know anything about that. And it was kind of new in Sweden, too, because we didn't start dubbing TV shows until 1988. So they just started doing that. Yeah. I mean, the big feature movies was dubbed, of course, from the 60s, I think, or something like that. But the regular cartoon shows in the Saturday mornings didn't start until 88, I think.
Were there original Sweden-made creations?
Yeah, there were more of that. And there were like when someone just says what the characters are saying, reading over it and stuff like that.
Well, I'll be jumping around questions all throughout this whole thing. Forgive me for that. But okay. I do have to ask then, is there much of a difference between a native Sweden-made cartoon or, you know, any other voice acting work versus a foreign-made thing, a dub? Are there any big differences between them?
Well, Sweden doesn't make that much original cartoons, actually. It's maybe two or three big features a year and nearly no TV shows at all. Not that I know of. So it's really rare to have not dubbed things in Sweden when it's cartoons. And it's too bad, because that would be so much fun. Yeah.
But are there any differences in terms of, say, the method or the, you know, because it's, trying to find the right words here, because it's more of a synchronizing issue is what I'm asking about. Do, with foreign made things, is there a synchronization issue when it comes to saying the lines or anything? Is there anything you have to take things like that into consideration?
Yes. Well, the mouths, the flapping of the mouth, we have to do that. And so it really fits good. And we also have to, you know, the timing and all, we have to start at the right time and stop the line at the right time. And we have to speak in the right voice and then also keep track of so we don't speak Swedish with an English accent. that really sounds dubbed and weird. So we never do that. It's really different. The melodies of the languages are really different. So as long as you do that, it's all good.
So carrying on from when you got started, where did you go from there? Where does the story continue?
Oh, sorry. I read in the Twilight's Magic, the flapping of the mouth sounds like the silence of the land. The flapping of the mouth.
Oh, trust me. Wait about it. In about 40 minutes, you're going to get bombarded with some weirder questions. So if you think mine are terrible, just keep waiting.
Oh, no, they're not terrible. Just go on. I just saw that one. It was in bright orange. It's like, attention, look at me. I'm writing in bright orange. Come on. But your question was, what was your question again? Sorry. How it started with the voices.
Yep. So you were already, you decided to
Yes.
On a serious matter. So where
I was very serious.
I
even recorded at home at a cassette. I actually recorded all the voices and all the characters to The Little Mermaid in my room, and I had really much fun. It took days to do that correctly. Now, but then, people said like, oh yeah, you should totally do that. And then I heard that, oh no, you have to live in Stockholm and you have to be a celebrity to do that. And I was like, oh, okay. So then I forgot about my dream. But then I moved to Stockholm and, well, I got an offer and they asked me, I'm a stand-up comedian and an impersonator too. So one day I was walking down the stage and someone told me to do a voice test and I did. Yes. Ta-da!
What was the voice test on?
It was a show called Dive Ollie Dive, or Tess och Ubbe in Swedish. And it was for the big national children's channel in Sweden. And I didn't understand that it was a voice test, because I was like, I'm just going to go there and they're going to check my timing and see if I even can act when it's, you know, so I was like, I'm just going to go there and maybe they're going to put me in their stack of voices, you know, a big pile of voices. But then when I was going to leave, they was like, oh, so let's see if you get the part. Yeah, I'm going to call you tomorrow and tell you if you got it. And I was like, oh, well. And then I got nervous. I was like, oh dear. And then they called me and said, yeah, you nailed it.
One restless night later.
Yeah. Oh, I was so happy. I was jumping up and down and I was so happy because that little girl, she got her dream.
Exactly. That's what I would say. You made your dream real.
Yes, I did. So that was nice. That's a nice memory. Aw, walking down memory lane. That's nice.
Isn't it always?
It's always.
So how did you then go? So how does the story continue? You landed your first role. So how did you pick up the speed?
Well, I guess that they thought that I did a good job because they called me again. And then other studios called me. And then, you know, here I am. So, I think it helps also that I do a lot of voices since I'm an impersonator. I have a very much control over my voice, so I can, I mean, one day I can be cast as a little boy, and one day an old lady, and one day a teenage guy, and one day, you know, just regular woman. So they can use me a lot. So, yeah.
So would you say versatility is a necessity?
It's not a necessity per se, but it's a good thing.
Sorry. In terms of what kind of training would you suggest that anyone who would be serious in taking this get?
I really think that it helped to record. I mean, I got a tape recorder when I was 6 because I really wanted to sing on it and I just wanted to record stuff. And I really got to know my voice. And that's a very good thing to do because I know people are like, I mean, general, my friends are like, if I record them, it's like, no, oh no, I sound so weird on, you know, is that how I sound? Oh no, I don't like my voice. Oh, and that's the thing you have to get over. It's like, this is the voice you have, okay? Get to love it because it's a good voice. So you have to do that. And then you can start experimenting with your voice and see where it takes you. Just try a very low one or a really high-pitched one. Or just a crazy one. I don't know. Yeah, the crazy one was fun.
That leads to two other questions. Sorry.
No, sorry.
I do have to ask, how do you deal, and this is more of a technical issue, how do you deal with the break in the voice?
The breaking the what? When
the voice breaks, you know, between your low pitch to your very high pitches.
Oh yeah, I use it because it's very good. Actually, I have trained to do that in the right places. So when I dub, I know how to get my voice to get a really crack of the voice. I use that to sound. To sound crazy. It's very good when you do that. When you're gonna play Eve, I'm gonna shout, so I'm gonna be a little bit away from the mic. So when you do like you have to do like this and be like this, it's not sounding good at all, but it sounds really real, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
It's like, I'm upset now.
Well, hopefully not at us.
I'm totally upset at you. No.
Well, I'm just going to then go ahead like and end this right there. Here.
Yeah. That's Snip's voice. Oh, yeah. Sorry.
Oh, please. Randomness is the spice that makes this show interesting. So
yeah.
Go for it.
Random silliness is magic.
What would you say? Oh, what was the question I was going to ask? I'm sorry, that last squeak kind of threw me off. I know what I was going to ask.
That's why I did it.
That where we're going with this, huh? Controlled chaos within this interview.
Controlled chaos is magic too.
So who, I know you're not going to, who are your favorite characters specifically to voice act?
Oh, Yeah, evil ones. The villains.
Why?
Because there's so much energy and I mean, it's so far away from who I am, so I really get to act. Because, I mean, I can play just a nice woman, just, you know, a mom. Like, you know, oh, drive safe, have a nice breakfast, da-da-da-da. But it's really more fun to be the villains. Or like Spike, just a little cute guy who just does little things and a bit of greediness to that. It's fun.
What is it that makes the villains so much? Are there any specifics that you maybe didn't list that make them fun? Maybe I'm repeating myself and having you repeat yourself consequently, but are there any things specifically to villains that make them so much fun to voice act?
They're so explosive. I mean, they have a lot of, you know, you get to do the evil laughter and stuff. That's always fun. I mean, it's always when I get a villain, I just start jumping up and down in the studio because I know, oh, maybe I will get to do the laugh. And actually, when I do that, when I record that, I even hold my hands out like that, you know, like they do. So I have so much fun with it. And I was like, oh, can I have one more take? And they're like, why? We got it. But it's fun because I never get to do that in real life, because if you do that in real life, it's crazy. So, you know, you never do that. I do it by myself all the time. Evil laughing. Just go around, you know. Just kidding.
Care to demonstrate?
Oh, yeah, sure. Let's see. What I lose. I'm going to stand up for this. So I'm like this.
Yes. Oh, trust me. Evil laughter is not lost here. What are any specific characters that have stuck with you in terms of the most memorable ones? Which ones were your favorites to voice? Which specific characters were your favorites to voice act?
I think that Tigress from Kung Fu Panda 2 is one of my favorites because that was the first really big movie character that I got. And that was really something. I was really happy to get that one.
Speaking of, you said you've done all sorts of different characters, you know, like Spike and Tigress. I do have to ask, are there any specific differences between male and female characters when voice acting them?
I mean, of course the voices are different, but when I speak, when I'm a guy, I always like do like this, so I'm a little dude, so like, I'm like here if I'm like a teenager, and I'm like here if I'm just a little guy. So I changed my S sound. And I also speak a little more southern Stockholm accent. Yeah.
Really?
When I do that. I don't know why, I just do that. So Spike has a lot of southern in him.
Now I want to shift to behind the microphone. What's going through your head when you're there? Whether it be villain or hero, man or woman, any character, what is running through your head?
Not that much, actually, because I'm so concentrated. I mean, I really concentrate a lot because, you know, the timing and listening to the original and getting it as perfect as I can, matching the original. I'm really into it, and I don't think about anything at all. I just do it, and sometimes when it's a really, you know, chatty sound engineer, we just chat a bit, and then we have some lines, and then we're like talking, you know. But sometimes the studios are really booked, so we have to really hurry up, and so we don't have time for the chatting, so we have to chat afterwards. It's like, oh, I want to say so much things to you, but let's work, and then talk. Okay, good.
Are you, go ahead, I'm sorry.
No, that was all.
Are there, now, bear in mind, I'm asking this because I genuinely don't know. Are you oftentimes there with the other voice actors and actresses, or are you often alone?
I'm always alone because in Sweden, we never record. We're always alone behind a glass shield, and there is a sound engineer and or a director too. So that's all. But we sometimes, if we're lucky, we meet other people when we go to the coffee room. And we'll say, hi, what show are you on? I'm on that show. Oh, I'm too. Yeah, I'm your grandma in that show. Oh, cool. I actually played a grandma to a guy who is 76 a couple of weeks ago. I was like, I'm your grandma! Who's your grandma?
There's some Doctor Who strange level stuff there, I'll tell you that much. Oh, what else? Are there any... trying to get this out here. Is there any much difference between voicing the pony characters or anything special to them in comparison to others?
Sorry, now I was reading the chat again. I'm sorry. I just have a question here. Can I answer it?
Yeah, sure.
I just saw that Arthurus that I know I met at the Swedish Comic Con. Hi, Arthurus. He asks me, because there was a very southern pony in the Swedish MLP from Skåne, and he wonders if I did the voice of Cherry Jubilee, and yes, I did. Det var jag, fröken Cherry Jubilee. Så snackar hon. Ja, hon är glad. That's how she sounds. I just needed to address that question, so now I'm done.
Hey, no problem. So I'll repeat my question. Are there any differences in voicing the pony characters versus other characters?
No. Well, they're a bit closer to my heart, maybe, because I met so much people that enjoys the ponies. So, I mean, it's a little bit extra when I go in there. It's like, oh, I really hope they're going to like this. And I do. I mean, I always bring my best, my A game to the studio, of course, but it's just a little bit more when it's the ponies.
That does lead to another tangent I wanted to address. Mm-hmm. What's so special about the pony fandom then to you? What makes it worth giving that 0.01% more?
Well, I met a lot of you guys, and I mean, I'm amazed every time I meet you, because I mean, all the warmth and the friendliness and the creativity and the love, it's just It's a very special thing to me. It's really dear to my heart. And yeah, there's so many good things I can say about the Brony fandom.
Is that why you're so involved within it on the side?
Yes.
Do you think...
I mean, I didn't know anything about you guys until I got an invitation to the German Convention GalaCon in 2012. I didn't know anything about this. So I was overwhelmed.
Go ahead, sorry.
Oh, I'm done.
I was going to ask, so how did you respond to all of that when you got invited to the German Comic Con?
GalaCon.
Or GalaCon, okay. Yep.
Yeah. At first I got an email and they asked me if I would be interested to go to Germany. And I was like, oh, wait, I'm in a Swedish version. Why would you like, I mean, thank you so much, but why would you like to invite me? And they said, oh, haven't you seen this? And then they sent me a link to a YouTube clip when someone had posted my Spitfire lines with Fry from Futurama reacting to what I said.
I've seen that video.
Yeah. And I was like, what? They time stretched me. Someone time stretched me. And they were like, I think 110,000 views, something like that. And a lot of comments. And I actually, I did read them all.
I have to ask.
Yeah.
How did you react to that?
Oh, no comments. No, just kidding. Some of the comments made me go, ew. And some of the comments made me go, aw. Most of them made me go, aw, that's cute.
Well, good.
Yes.
So then how did your popularity within here take off from there? How did you see it? How did you experience it?
I went to GalaCon. I had a lot of fun. And then they asked me to 2 weeks before I went there, they asked me to start Twittering. And I was like, Twitter now, what now? I didn't know what it was. I was like, I mean, I heard it, but it's like, why would anyone, I mean, why would I go on Twitter? I don't have time, and I don't know what it is. Does it hurt? Is it dangerous?
Does it hurt?
Does it hurt? Twittering? It sounds like Twittering. No, but, and I thought, oh, well, I can help them with some PR for the convention, sure. So I joined Twitter, and then like an hour later, I had a lot of followers. I mean, they, a lot. Like, I don't remember, not 1,000, but something like that. It was like, oh, okay. I just sat there and like, should I write something? So I wrote like, hi, everypony, something like that. And I got answers. I was like, oh, cool. And then I just, you know, Twitter just stuck on me, I guess.
I'll say your presence on there is unequaled. I'm not kidding when I say you could tweet to several people, but one of the nice things if I may compliment on screen here, thank you for taking the time and energy that you do to respond and at the very least favors our replies to you.
Aww. Well, thank you. I mean, I really want to answer everyone, and I want to favorite a lot because I really want to show people that I have read what they wrote to me, and I don't want to miss out on anything. So when I'm away for a couple of days or something like that, I mean, on a vacation or something, I just come back and then I want to see what's going to be going on Twitter. Sometimes I have to take time off from Twitter because my family wants me to sometimes. It's like, I don't want to. They're like, come on. No computer, no phones. Come on. I'm like, okay. Would you give me candy? And they'd be like, yes. And then they do.
Dear, we need to talk.
Yeah. It's like, if you don't go on Twitter for 2 days, I will give you some Tabasco, okay? Okay. I love Tabasco.
I was going to say, is that your favorite food or sauce or something?
It's my favorite food. Today I had Tabasco with a meatball. Woo! No, yeah. I really like hot sauces in general. Nice. I think Twitter knows that. I post pictures of, oh, look.
I saw that one not that long ago. Someone sent you about like 6 or so vials of Tabasco sauce.
Yes.
I was curious about that.
Oh, yes. I don't know how it started. I mean, I went to DerbyCon South in New Orleans last year, and I bought some. I mean, that's where they make Tabasco, and I didn't know that. So when I came there and found out on the last day, I was like, no, because I wanted to go to the factory, you know. But it was like 1 day left. I was like, why? It was a really long why. 5 minutes why. And I was like, I'm going to go back to New Orleans just to visit that place. I need to do that. So, but I did find a store and I bought a lot of sauce home. And then I ran out of it. I think I tweeted something like that. Oh no, something like that. The people offered because they didn't have that brand in Sweden.
Right.
And now they do have one of the brands, but not the other one. So. But it's so funny because now I have a lot of Tabasco. So it's okay now. in a couple of months, I'd be like, oh no. No, I just have to go to the U.S. really soon again and just buy all the cool candies and hot sauces there are there because I just need to do that really soon.
All I can imagine is just you have this giant stash of Tabasco sauce hidden behind a bookcase or something.
I don't. It's actually in a kitchen cabinet, so and one shelf it's Tabascos. I think I don't know how many. It's 12 or something. I think it's more. So when I was cooking with the friends a couple of weeks ago, and someone opened the cabinet, it's just like, I know you like hot sauce, but hey, what's this? I was like, well. It's presents.
Exactly.
It's mine.
If you lived in my house, you could arrange it your way. But this is my house, and in my house, we have a whole shelf of Tabasco sauce.
Of course. I mean, who doesn't have that?
Oh, that is rich. I like that. Partially, it's because I can relate, but I'll save that for another time.
Oh, hot sauce high five.
Wham.
Yours said wham. Mine said dish. I have a lady high five dish.
I was channeling the Todd from Scrubs there, so bear with me.
Oh, well, now the chat is talking about peppers and stuff. peppers in general.
They go off on some tangents, yeah. I'll tell you that much.
Oh, yeah. They're talking about the sauce now. Hi, Quasi.
Speaking of convention travels, tell us some of the other conventions you've been to.
I've been to GalaCon in Germany twice, and it's so fun because I gotten to know a couple of people there. It's so nice to befriend people. I mean, there's so much fun people to just be around there. It's really nice. And now on Twitter, they're like, I don't know how many, but maybe 20 people that I actually met IRL. So it's like, hi! I have a face to that name now. So that's really, I think it's more than 20, actually. Yeah, it must be. And I have been to, DerpyCon South in New Orleans. And I've been to Crystal Fair in Finland. That was this summer. And, I went to the Super Winter Brony Party in this awesome name, Super Winter Brony Party in London. And, Czechquestria in Czech Republic. The coolest convention name, Czechquestria. I mean, just get a taste of that. And then I went, Comic-Con in Stockholm, but that wasn't a pony convention. But it was still fun, but not as fun as a pony convention.
So they didn't have to be strictly pony conventions.
Oh, well, that's all my conventions. I just been to one non-pony convention.
So, yeah, I'll ask then, what are some differences between pony conventions and non-pony conventions?
Well, non-pony conventions, they have a lack of pony. So, I just been to one convention that wasn't pony, so I really can't compare them. I mean, it was really fun being at Comic-Con. I mean, that's like, whoa, that's cool. And I'm going to Heartwarming Eve in Amsterdam in Holland this February.
Nice.
Yes. I'm looking forward to it.
This mostly concerns DerpyCon South in particular, but what made you pick various conventions to go to? There are several of them in Europe and certainly several of them here. What makes you pick a convention?
I'm not that picky, you know. I'm just happy if they invite me. No, but I mean, if I have time and can make time in my schedule, I mean, there's no hesitation. I really love the conventions. I really do. So, yeah. I mean, I'm very happy to be invited, and it's so much fun. So I'm really hoping for more conventions because that's just so nice to meet everyone IRL and just hang out and talk. And just I think my favorite thing is not the panels or the signings. It's just my favorite thing is just to go around the vendors hall and just, you know, just hang out with people and talk and just, you know, move around there and just check out the things and talk to people. Yeah.
What's number two on that list? I need to ask.
Panels is always fun. I get to talk about things that I love. So that's nice. Everything in the convention is nice. It's really nice. It's not nice. It's fun. I mean, I'm happy several weeks before I go to a convention. I'm like, oh, I'm going to a convention. Nervous sided.
Do you get the post-con blues?
Yes, I do. Ugh. I do. And I posted, I Googled it and I was like, is it normal to feel this way after a convention? And yes, it was. It's like 2 days or something after, it's like, oh, so much fun and all the memories. Oh yeah, now it's memories. It's not going on anymore. It's like, oh.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Kind of channeling off of this convention bit and what you like, but I'm going to kind of jump back a little bit to the voice acting. Mm-hmm. Wherein lay your passions? What makes you get up in the morning and do this?
Just the fun of it, just to play around with different voices and try to make the cartoons as alive as they can be. and do a really good job, because I have very high standards on myself when it comes to my voices and my dubbing and my singing, of course, and the comedy. But I mean, especially when it comes to the voicing, because I don't want people to feel like, oh yeah, this is the dubbed version, this is dubbed. I don't want that. I want people to don't even think about it. And sometimes, yeah, that's really important to me. So just wake up and I feel like, oh, today I get to go to the studio and play around with voices again. The sillier, the better. So, yeah.
What are roles that you do? I'm trying to avoid asking you what are your favorite roles to play here, but I have to. But I'm going to ask, when you're picking roles, not necessarily in the sense of like, you know, you want to get the villain or you want to get this or that. How is the process of how you determine who you play decided?
Oh my gosh, really? We don't get to pick roles. It never happens. The casting directors, they call us and they say, okay, so you're going to do this, this, and this. Can you do it tomorrow? We never have anything to say about it. So it's just, they cast as they see fit. So yeah, we have to roll with what we get.
So typecasting becomes a big fear?
well, then I would be a lot of moms. So yeah, that's a fear. I mean, if the moms aren't like crazy or something, that would be fun. No, but no, there's no typecasting going on. I don't think so. But whew. Since I do a lot of voices, I often get to be a lot of smaller characters, like a lot of them. Like in one show, I can be 10 smaller characters because I can do different voices. And then like my characters talk to each other sometimes. So I think my record is when I was 3 characters and they talked with each other. It was like, okay. But they have different voices and accents, so that was cool. But I mean, it was like, oh, cool. I get to talk to myself. 3 persons, yeah.
That brings up another point I want to address. What's it like to be speaking with yourself that many times or that often?
it's really funny because in Pony, I think there's once, I think Cheerilee is speaking to Spike, and then Sweetie Belle comes along, and that's me, all of them. So Sweetie Belle's here, and then she's talking to Cheerilee, who's up here, and then Spike is here, so they're talking to each other. But then when I do, it happened twice in shows that I have the same, that my character gets duplicated or something like that, and they're like talking to themselves, and that's really fun. I think in Disney's Kid vs. Cat, my character Coop, the kid, he duplicated himself, like he was 4 of him or something, and they were all agreeing, planning stuff towards the cat, and that was kind of like, whoa, okay, is it me now? No, it's me. Okay, so is this the old me, or is this the me who was talking, like,
That existential and then, of course, crisis.
Yeah, and of course, in the Little's Pet Shop, I'm Miss Twombly, and I'm the Biscuit Twins. So I get to talk to myself a lot as the Biscuit Twins.
Do you have any... No, I'll say that for later. But what I can ask you is... When you're behind the microphone, is it... And this is just more for everyone's benefit as well as mine. Are you just reading the lines? Or what's the more... What separates a good voice acting session from a bad one?
I only do good, so I don't know. No, just kidding. Well, you just never. I mean, I don't ever just stand there and read the things, because that would be that I wouldn't have a job. So I read them as natural as I can, because I haven't seen the scripts before. So I just, I just, you know. It's hard to explain because we never get the script beforehand. So we stand there and it's like the next line and then okay and then the next line. So
it sounds like it's a lot of improvising.
It is. It is. But as long as we stick to the text, it's okay.
What's the director doing as you're doing this or the sound guy?
Yeah, he tells me, or she tells me, if the line is too short or too long, or if the sound is off or something, like the microphone can be like a little off or something, or if I was kind of sloppy with one word that I didn't, it's like, okay, I can't hear when you say that, can you pronounce it a little bit better, something like that. And when we have a director, they are more like, okay, that feeling, can you get more of that? And the good thing is that when you really know the director, they know how to talk to you in that way. So, I mean, if he says, oh, but more sunshine in it, or more umbrella in it, I know what it is, so I do it. So you get that own language with the directors that you work a lot with. But that's fun.
What about singing roles? I know singing? That, yeah. Singing. Yeah. I know you told me you sing. I know you sing in MLP. So what of singing roles? What of?
Well, the Biscuit Twins in Little Pet Shop, they sing sometimes. I think they sang 3 times, I think. And Disney's Fish Hooks. På Kroken, I'm a bee, the goldfish, and she sings a lot. And I also did the other songs in that show. When it just says singer in the scripts, it's also me. And then, sometimes characters just sing a little bit and never more. So, So when it says that I'm about to sing, I just sing. Yeah, I think Pound Puppies, I sang something there too. Yeah, I did. A Christmassy thing, I think.
Aww.
Yeah. I think my puppy is called, I think my puppy, let's see, something really, really sweet. Like, oh no, what's it called? Oh, it's a beige little puppy with a pink. Oh.
Darn it. I can see it. I know who you're referring to, but I don't get that.
Clee Summers does the original voice for him. Oh no, I can't remember. Oh well. Yeah, something like cake, puppy cake, no?
Problem is I don't get the former Hub, now Discovery Family Network. So I didn't, outside of Pony, which is streamed, I don't get the chance to watch much of it. So you'll have to bear with me on that.
Oh, it's okay. But it's you. I always remember the name of my characters. So why can't I remember this one? It's up on Netflix over here. Okay. Oh, well. Soon I'm going to shout it out when I remember. It's going to be in the back of my head now. And then he's going to be like, rah, that's the name of them.
Stick to the chat. They'll probably tell us.
Chat, do you know what I mean?
Let's ask the audience.
Let's ask the audience. Let's see. No one knows. No one watches Pound Puppies.
Which is sad. I heard it's a good show.
Yeah, it's cute. Does anyone here, excuse me, does anyone here watch the Pound Puppies? Because we don't have the name for the puppy that I voice in Sweden. No, no one? Oh, thanks anyway. Just kidding.
Give him a minute.
I just had
a literal minute, because...
literal minute.
Because it takes time for it to transfer between us and us to them.
Yeah.
But what about some singing that you do outside of TV shows and television? Do you do any of that?
Yeah, but not so much right now because I don't have the time, but I would like to sing more. I would like to. I mean, I sang at Crystal Fair this summer in Finland. I sang with Daniel Ingram.
Wow.
Yes, that was wow. I was fangirling. Yes, I was.
Was he going nuts because he was meeting you?
Oh, yeah. You should have seen the guy. He was all over the place like, wow. No, just kidding. He was like, oh, hi. I don't know if he even knew who I was at first. But he accompanied me playing the guitar, and I sang You'll Play the Part.
Yep, You'll Play Your Part.
Yeah, You Play That Part. You Play Your Part. You Play That Part. So that was fun. And I, as I said before, I have really high standards. And I never, almost never go on stage and, you know, now I'm going to go on stage and I'm going to sing pretty. Because I always never do that, because I'm a comedian. I'm a stand-up comedian. And I always, I mean, if I sing something on stage, something funny or something, when I sound weird or something. But I never go on stage like, and now time for some beautiful singing. So That was really new to me. It's like, oh dear.
We're closely wrapping up the first hour here, so we're going to be going to the audience very soon. Audience, start throwing your questions into the room, the other room.
The other room.
Yeah, there's another room. I'll be putting it here.
Mm-hmm. And I'm looking for the name of that pound puppy. It's really cute. It's the cutest name ever. It's like Sugar Sprinkles, but it's not Sugar Sprinkles because that's another show. But oh, here it is. Let's see. Yes, I'm Cupcake.
That has got to be one of the cutest Cupcake. Names for a dog I've ever
Isn't
heard.
Isn't it?
It is.
It's really ponylicious too. Cupcake!
Cupcakes!
He's like, hi. He's like, I'm Cupcake and I'm Sugar Sprinkles.
Oh.
And I'm both of them, so it's fun. I'm so sweet. I try to be.
One of the...
You'll push that cart. That Twilight is magic. It's funny. You're funny. You'll push that cart.
Speaking of the music, though, I do have one... Speaking of the music, not just necessarily in ponies, but was there a specific song that you... Is there a specific song you like to sing? What's your favorite song?
Like in the whole big world?
Yeah, let's start there.
It's Barbie Girl by Aqua. No. Sometimes, yes, sometimes. If I'm at a party, it totally is. It's like if we're in a, you know, where there's karaoke, I always sing I Will Always Love You by Whitney Houston, and I always sing Barbie Girl by Aqua. And so people are always like, oh, you should sing some Celine Dion or something really nice. And nah, I'm just going to go with Barbie Girl. No, why do you do that? Come on, you should share. You should sing something. You have pretty boys. Come on, sing it. And like, nah, I'm going to go with Barbie Girl. It's fun. I want to have fun. I want to sing fun things. I just sing like beautiful. I can do that in the studio, but I want to sing fun things on stage.
I could just picture the, your friends or the people at the party anyway going, oh no.
Yeah. Yeah. They're like, again? Yes. Really? Yes. Really? It's like, I'm a Barbie girl in a Barbie world. So I have so much fun with it. And then I was forced one of my guy friends to be Ken. And they're like, no, I don't want to be Ken. I'm like, come here. You got to be Ken now, okay? And he's like, oh, yeah, okay.
Do me a favor. Next time you go to a convention, sing that.
I'm going to sing Barbie Girl. No, Barbie is not pony. Come on. Come on. No, but I always sing karaoke at conventions. I always, actually, I mail before I go date an email, and I say, is there going to be a karaoke there? Because that's fun. And they was like, yes, they're going to be, yay. I love singing karaoke. So I do that at every convention. And in Holland, at I'm gonna actually be the hostess of the karaoke. So if you're going to Holland at the convention there, just a heartwarming convention, just go there and I will sing with you.
Nice.
Yes. It's going to be fun. And I don't know why, but I really love Pinky's Lament. Because I don't sing that in Swedish because I'm not her, but it's a very nice song. What? And I really like to make my voice sound like this. So it's a funny song to sing.
I've got one more question before we move to the audience questions. Mm-hmm. What would be your magnum opus? What is the one thing you want to go out as?
I want to go out as?
Yeah, as like, what would be your crowning moment?
Oh, wow, my crowning moment. In which fields?
It is a pretty broad question, so yeah. Forgive me for that. How about...
Okay,
go ahead.
If it's about voice acting, I would love to be a princess, a Disney princess.
Nice.
Just because that's a little like a girl dream. I really like that.
How about here in the pony fandom? What would be the one thing you'd want to be remembered for?
I'm very happy with Spitfire, so. Yeah. Fair and enough. I hope people like the other ones too, but I mean, yeah. I try. I like it.
I like that. I really do. All right, as promised, it's the audience question time. So, audience,
bring it.
One last time, throw your questions into
the question room.
I'll read them as many as I can get, but I make no promises. All right.
Oh, I'm reading here. Yeah, the Equestria Girls, the first movie that came out. I sang a lot in that one too.
Really.
The choir things, and I sang A Friend for Life, you know, in the credits. Yeah.
Nice.
It was fun.
Alicorn Texas Boy asks, what would you like to see in season 5?
What I would like to see? A whole episode with Spike. No. a whole episode with just my characters talking to each other. That would be like a roller coaster of craziness, I think. At least to record it.
I could just. How do you put Spike, Cheerilee, Sweetie Belle, and Spitfire all in one episode?
Yeah, and Cadence and Chrysalis too. Add them to the and photo finish. Don't forget about her. Yes. She will be there. Well.
Well, you know what they say. You know you have good characters and a good story when you can just put your characters in a room and have them go nuts.
Oh yeah! All my characters can do that. That's typecasting for you.
He also asks, Alicorn Texas Boy asks, is it easy to keep track of one's voice when you're voice acting?
No. Well, it can be. Maybe in let's say, for example, Phineas and Ferb, I'm a couple of minor characters there, and they're not, I mean, they are recurring characters, but not that, I mean, they're there in like one or two episodes a season. So maybe I come in for that and I'm like, oh, how did I make this mom or this little girl? How did I, and they can actually show me how I did it. So, but it's really not that often because I write everything down I do. So when I come home, I write, which character I voiced and how I put my voice to remember it. So next time I get booked for that, I can go back to that little document.
Sure.
Yes.
I have a bit of a follow-up question to mm-hmm. that. Do you make... Sorry.
Do I make... What are you trying to say? Are you censoring something now?
No.
No.
No, what I do want to ask is, do you get any of the recordings, not the TV show itself, but any recordings of your own voice to use for later, you know, for references and stuff?
Yes, I actually did a little show reel because I have a new webpage. It's two or three weeks old, my new webpage. The first one was 4 years old. So, but my webpage is nice. It's actually www.anneliheed.com. And on there, there is actually a show reel that I edited together. And actually, it wasn't me editing it, but it's okay. I was good at that. I was like, I'm going to learn stuff. I don't want to learn stuff. Can you do it for me, please? I give you candy. No, but it's actually up on YouTube.
Right.
Maybe I can find it and send you the link so you can hear some of my voices. And that's actually some ponies in there. Let's see if I can find it and send you a link.
I was going to say, if you wanted to do that, in the meantime, I'll get a couple more questions here going.
Yes.
Let's see.
It's the short show reel because the first one I intended to do was 10 or 15 minutes long. It's like, oh, people don't want to see all of this. So it's like, so this is 2 minutes long. That's too much.
Mr. Ben asks, I'm sorry, go ahead.
Oh, no, I'm just singing.
Okay.
I'm never quiet. So should I put it in the chat room maybe?
If you want, yeah, that would... Either that or if you want, you can send it to me and I'll do that.
can do it myself. I'm a big girl. There it is. Oh, no, the smiley turned. Oh, wow, the smiley is a rarity head. I am pony-95389.
If you wanted to change that, we can do that.
No, that's okay. I like Rarity. I mean, I'm at Tabitha. I like Rarity.
No, I was meaning the name, the pony 95389.
But... Oh, no. That's okay. It has a certain flair to it. Kind of not.
Darn it, Matt. Anyway, Mr. Ben asks, has his first five questions. Mr. Ben has his standard set.
Uh-huh.
He's been with me since about day one, so yeah, I can vouch for this. What is your favorite flavor of ice cream?
Ooh, num num num. Something with nuts and sweet, like, oh, what's the name in English? Oh, fudge. Yeah, fudge and nuts. Yes, that's good.
If you could manipulate, yeah, I can use Ben since you are several characters in Avatar, The Legend of Korra.
Yeah.
So I'm going to use that phrase. If you could bend any two of the four elements from that show, which would they be?
Two of the four, you said?
Yes.
Well, fire is cool to bend. And water, maybe? But air is cool, too. Now I think fire and water, yeah.
All right. Yeah, you actually got kicked. Let me...
The chat kicked me out. I wrote something really inappropriate, I guess. The chat room was like, no!
No, what happened is we have an auto-kick script in for videos during a stream.
I thought they
were all I got turned auto off. Kicked. I'm sorry. Yep, so it was an auto
like
kick.
Something from Transformers Prime, like, oh, you got auto kicked. But I'm an Autobot, come on. I'm RC.
I gave you the means to get RC. Back in, so don't worry.
Okay.
Anyway, next question. Wow, we've got a truckload of questions here, and I love it.
Awesome. I want to get into the chat again. How do I do it? Oh, you sent me a link?
Yep, just check in there. I gave you the instructions there.
Oh, yeah. So it's just type this in the chat. Join. Okay. Da, da, da. I'm going to fix it so I can read it all again.
Twilight is magic. Go ahead. Sorry.
No, I did it. No, nothing happens. Okay. Maybe the wrong window. Let's see here. No. Oh, no. I can't get into the chat.
I'll get that fixed. Okay. If anything, just refresh the chat stream.
I'm going to hit that. I left the chat. Let's see how this goes. This is so funny when it's live. It's like, oh, no.
Isn't it?
Yeah. Now I'm going to join it again. I'm just going to... Okay. Continue, please.
All right.
I'm in now, I think. Oh, no. I hear myself. Like...
There we go. Yeah, you're back.
Uh-oh.
You're fine. You're...
I'm derping.
There we go. Now you're back.
I'm back. Woohoo.
Woohoo! Twilight is Magic asks,
yes?
What do you like the most about the pony phenomenon, both in terms of the way it is in general and in terms of interacting with us bronies?
What I like the most of it? Can you just say it again, please? Hello?
Yes, we're still here.
Can you say it again, please?
Sure. Twilight is Magic asks, mm-hmm. What do you like the most about the pony phenomenon, both in terms of the way it is in general and in terms of interacting with us pony fans?
It's It's a two-way question. that's what confused me. The first thing I think it's that I think it's so cool that an animated show gets so much attention from adults. I think that's really cool. And the second thing is, I always say that. I mean, you can't be too old for fun, and you don't have to be a certain gender to enjoy fun, and you don't have to be, you know, in any way to enjoy fun things.
Exactly.
So I'm very happy that this broadens the horizons of many people. And the second one is what I enjoy most of the pony fandom. Yes, I said before, the creativity and all the kindness. And the coolest thing, I think, is that a person can come from another continent to another place, and I mean, he or she doesn't know anyone there at the convention. And then 5 minutes later, he's one of them. I mean, you're so welcoming. It's really nice, and people just find friends all over the world, and it's just a very beautiful thing.
It is.
It is.
Ugh. Venher asks, do you like corn?
Corn?
Yes.
I do! How did you know?
Oh, then you're going to get along quite well here.
I love corn. I mean, that was like, all of the food in America. I mean, there's a lot of corn there. And I ate a lot of corn, yes. I mean, the city of New Orleans, I mean, wow, the Louisiana food was lovely.
I bet.
Oh, yes.
Good old Deep South goodness there.
Yes. In Sweden, we don't have that food at all. I mean, people, like, when they get something that's a little bit spicy, it's like, oh, I can't have this. It's too spicy. Do you have something that's not, like, too spicy? And I'm like, no, I don't have anything, like, not too spicy. People in Sweden have the California accent. Yeah.
all I can imagine.
They do like a lot.
All I can imagine is when you drown your food in the Tabasco sauce, everyone just goes, oh, no.
Yeah, that's why I'm not allowed to make chili for my friends anymore. They're like, don't let Anneli go near that thing because she will destroy it with like, the rooster sauce and everything. And you know, she's, no, don't let her do that. Do that to your own plate. Don't do that to all of us. We can't handle it because we are sissies. No.
Fight through the pain, darn it.
Yeah, learn the hard way, okay? No, but it's really good. I mean, I love it, but I never cook chili for my friends anymore. Yeah. We had to order takeout. I was like, I didn't have anything in there. I said, yes, yeah, but a little bit. But I mean, it has to taste something.
Exactly. I mean, what, you want just some bland stuff?
Yeah.
Give it some flavor, literally.
Yes. And we have two. I mean, people never eat corn over here. It's like, why?
Check out Tim's comment there in the chat. You'll like it.
Which one? Let's see.
His last one. His latest one.
Tim?
Twilight is magic.
Oh, yeah. Oh, of course. Yeah, I know. I'm Pinky.
all the spicy stuff.
I'm Pinky! That's really, really funny. No, I can't. Oh, when I see her lines in the scripts, I mean, they're like, wow, it's like a whole paper full of, you know, the same line. It's like, oh, when I see that, it's like I get tired just seeing it. It's like, oh dear.
When does it end?
Yeah.
Just flipping through the pages, it's like, where does it end?
There it ended. Yeah, but sometimes Spikes does those little rants too. He does them. So it's really funny to do that. And he's like, okay, so where am I supposed to breathe? So I'm like, you're not supposed to. Oh, okay, sure. I'm just going to do this.
Breathing's overrated. Get through it.
Yeah, exactly. Breathing? Oh, come on. That's so 18th century. We don't breathe anymore.
Mr. Ben asks, which character would you choose to voice act if you could choose which character to voice? That is, and it's not, it, He's specifying it has to be one that you are currently not doing.
In MLP?
Anything.
In anything? Ooh, because I know in MLP, I know, but... but, I don't know. Everything? Yeah, everything. And in MLP, I say everything. No, in MLP, I have two favorites. I have Fluttershy, who's like, you know, that would be so cool because he's really, really far away from who I am. I'm not even that shy, but it would be a challenge to do that. And I would like to be Rarity because she is so wonderful with all the darlings and stuff. And then she's like the worst possible thing ever. Oh! That would be funny.
That was awesome.
Thank you. Yeah, me and Tabitha and Jermaine, we actually did a rarity off at Crystal Fair in Finland. I wasn't prepared for that. Let's just say that.
But how did it end? I gotta ask.
Oh, well, it wasn't. I mean, I could never compete to the original, so yes, she won. And I also did a Fluttershy cute off at Galacon 2013 with Andrew Libman. That was really fun.
What were you trying to do? Give everyone a heart attack?
Yeah. No, but it was actually for charity. So I asked her, we sat there on stage, and it was the charity auction, and I just thought, like, oh, maybe we should try to do this and just see if it turns out fun. And I asked Andrea, and she was like, yeah, sure. So we improvised it, and it sold for, let's see, was it 200 euros or something?
Dang. Hmm.
Something like that, yes.
That's impressive.
We had fun.
I bet.
And it was for a good cause, and that's the best thing. I mean, I'm really, you know, the charity auctions of the fandom, and that's really a very nice part of it too. I think the live stream, yeah, that's the word I'm looking for. The 24-hour live streams, and you know, that's really amazing to see. I mean, how much you can make a difference for people. I'm very impressed every time I see something like that.
I can sympathize with that wholly. Let's see.
The bunnies. Oh, hi, Hexie! Hexaman is here. He says, oh no, the bunnies! Because Andrea said that.
Right.
And yep. I wasn't prepared for what she was going to say at the Galagon. So I was like, the bunnies? Yeah. Sorry.
Oh, no, no. Let's see here. Dark92 Enigma asks, okay, Ms. Heed, what's your favorite character, show, and episode that is not pony related?
Okay. Character, show, and episode. Is it going to be the same show, or can it just be randomly?
I think he didn't specify, so answer that however you see fit.
All right, so character. Right now, I can say that I have a lot of fun being... But it's not right now, but I have been before. So let's see. Wendy from Gravity Falls. Mm-hmm. I have a lot of fun being her because she's such a tomboy, and that's cool. And then character. That was character. And then show. And that was something else? Season.
Show and episode.
Episode. Show, not MLP, you said? Okay, yep. LPS. Because in Little Spaceship, I get to be a crazy old woman and two really cranky and snobby girls. That's fun. That's a lot of fun. And then the last one. What was it? The last one.
Your favorite episode from...
Yes, episode. let's remember that it's almost 12 in the night, in the middle of the night for me. So bear with me. That must be episode. Ooh, some of the episodes when I'm doing a lot of crazy things. Like, I think there's an episode of Fishhooks when Bee is going crazy over something. Yeah, she wants to go to a ball, like the prom or something, and she's missing out because she has to be in two places at the same time, and she can't do that possibly. And then she runs around and screams, and then she sings, and then she screams again. And that's really funny. Hysterical episode.
Ah, yada yada yada. Ah.
Yeah, exactly. Screaming. Exactly, and running. So he's like, it was so funny.
Oh my lord. Okay, here's one from Krim. Mm-hmm. He asks, "Hi, Ms. Heed. I'm Corey from Louisiana. From 2008,
Hi, Corey.
From 2008 to 2010, I've taken various acting classes for both film and theater. New Orleans is booming in the entertainment industry, and I have plans going back to go back into acting. From your experience, what advice can you give me to help my chances in said industry?"
Well, is it acting or on stage, or is it voice acting? You didn't specify that.
I didn't specify that either.
Well, because I've been in comedy shows, but I haven't been in anything dramatical like that. But I have been in comedy shows on stage, of course. And a good thing is to because I can understand that it's really hard for you if you haven't done anything yet, but maybe you're fresh out of school or something, and then you have to maybe you can do some free stuff in the beginning so you can get a portfolio, and then to take acting classes, a lot of acting classes, of course, and just to mingle and network with people, and then get yourself a good web page and tell everyone who wants to hear, "I'm an actor, I'm looking for jobs," and then collect everything to make a show reel, and then go to the agents and like, "I'm good. Hire me."
Let's see. Mr. Ben asks, "How much fire would Spitfire fire if Spitfire could spit fire?"
A lot of fire. That's all I have to say. A lot.
I told you these questions get random.
I love random, so keep them coming.
My Brony Side asks, "What would your own personal pony look like? If you were put there, what would it look like?"
I actually have a pony Sona called Swearfire, and she's yellow with a stand-up microphone as a cutie mark. And she has my old hairdo that I had, my old hairstyle when I had kind of short hair. So she has that. And but I have long hair now, but she's very cute. And Rautakova in Finland made her for me in 2012. Oh, I see that someone wrote Sweden Belle. That's cute.
I like that.
Sweden Belle. There's some things in the showreel, there's some Sweetie Belle. Some Sweden Belle for you. And actually, somewhere on YouTube, there is a squee when she says the Crystal Empire, like, something like that. And I said, Kristalliket. And it's, I had a really hard time. I think I did like 10 retakes on that one just to get the right. It's like, it's really hard to do that. So it's like, again, come on. He was like, okay, sure, okay.
I gotta ask, was your voice hoarse after that? No pun intended.
Yeah, because I was like, no, it wasn't. I'm very used to it, so it's not every day I come home from a studio and like, oh dear. Well, it happens sometimes if I have like long days, like 2 weeks with really long days. Mm-hmm. It can be like, okay, so I take a quiet day, as I call it, and I go around being quiet, and that's really not me because I talk all the time, and if I'm not talking, I make sounds. So people are like, it's so good because we always know where you are because you make sounds like when you're bored or something like that. You always do something like, na 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 na, something like that. People actually said, can you be quiet for just 1 second? Story of my life.
Oh, well, what fun is there in being quiet?
I know.
Okay, let's see. His other question, my Brony Side's question. By the way, if you want to post a link to your website, go for it. And I promise you, you won't get kicked for it.
Are you sure?
Okay. Yes, I'm very sure of it.
It's in Swedish, but you will see the character names and stuff is in... It's in English.
I might not be the smartest in.
I'll leave my name here.
I may not be the smartest in how things work around here, but I do have some general idea of how they do. So yes, I can promise you that you won't get kicked if you post it.
And anyway. Now I'm Pony 95389. Good.
Didn't get kicked.
Ah, good. I do a lot of these. Tomorrow I'm going to do, I can't say what it's for, but I'm doing, sometimes I do English things too. And tomorrow I'm going to read a long text in English. And it's kind of like that, like a lot of numbers and stuff.
It was the best of times. It was the worst of times.
Yes.
Let's see here. My Brony Side asks, if you were a professor at a college or university, what subject would you teach, a.k.a. what is your favorite subject in school?
Well, I think linguistics would be fun because I studied that for a while. So that would be fun, I think. Yeah. I would actually kind of know what I was talking about, so... Yeah, that would be fun. And I would be Professor Heed. That sounds fun.
That does. Professor Heed, how do I get my voice to be angelic like yours?
What are you talking about, angelic? I'm Angelica. Well, a lot of honey and water and... No. Oh, well.
Oh, my Lord. All right.
Someone wrote something about a chicken. It's Quasi. Hi. She says, ooh, I still have chicken. I don't know why she's writing that, but I like it. I mean, everything with chicken is good. So, I mean, keep on writing about chicken. Oh, it's ideas for artworks. Ooh, Heed your professor. That's funny, too. Anneli, you... Yes, I do that. He's like, you're always doing this to me. I will stop. If you want me to, I will stop.
It's because we're evil.
Evil.
Again, you wonder why I like this setup. Let's see. Last question from him. What other hobbies outside kind of worded a little bit weird?
I know what you mean. I think I know the question.
Okay, go for it.
What hobbies do I have outside my work? I'm very fortunate to say that my hobby is my work. So when I started dubbing, I tried to watch everything I did, but then it escalated and now I don't have time to watch it. But I try to... at least see something from everything I do, every show and movie. So, I'm really interested I'm always checking out the original actors and who is doing. I mean, if I dub over a voice for 5 hours, I want to know who am I dubbing over, and what have that person done before? Have I voiced something that person did before? And I have like kind of an over interest in in the business, I think. So I'm a dubbing nerd, a voice acting nerd.
That kind of raises a question that I was going to have.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Lost it. Sorry.
Oh, it will come back.
It will.
But then other things is like, you know, meeting my friends and traveling and, you know, stuff like that. I do that a lot too, so.
Nice.
Yes.
Twilight is Magic asks, what? Is the airspeed velocity of an unladen swallow? Or Pegasus, I'm sorry.
Huh? I just heard Pegasus.
What is the airspeed velocity of an unladen Pegasus?
Oh. Yellow?
That was probably the best answer you could have given.
Yeah. I figured.
Oh my Lord. Go on.
Yeah. Are you okay?
I'll be fine. I'll be fine. I've been down this road before.
Take a moment. He's like, is this going to be us laughing for 5 minutes? People are like, come on, come on.
Yellow. I think better than random questions are random answers like that.
Oh, I'm a random girl.
Okay.
Professional random girl. That's me.
Okay. Okay, I really am done.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure. Fender asks, who is your favorite voice for a character, either pony related or not pony related?
Favorite voice? Well, it depends on the character, who it is, the gender and age and the style of personality. So it really depends. If I do a lot of really low voices like this for 2 or 3 days, it's like, it's really nice to get up here and do something like this. Like, that's nice. I think actually the last 6 months I haven't done that much. I call it pitch voice. I want to do this. So I was really happy the other day when they gave me something so I can sell it like this. It was fun.
Aww.
Yeah.
How about... Ooh, Crazy Rabbit Pony asks, what is your favorite movie?
I like the comedies. And I like the... One of my favorites is actually A Night at the Roxbury. I don't know if you know it.
I do not. I've never heard of it.
It's a very funny movie with the guys from Saturday Night Live. And it's a 90s movie. It's from 96 or something, 97. No, it was later. It's in the 98 or something. That's a really funny movie.
Good year.
It's a very silly movie. I like silly movies, so.
Flutterlights asks, what is your favorite book?
Oh. Well, there's so many. There's a book called Tuesdays with Maury. That's really good. It's a very deep book about life and you know, serious questions about life and love. And, you know, that's nice. And, yeah, that's one of my favorites. Yeah.
Okay.
I read a lot, but I always, like, when I'm done, I'm like, I forget it. Then I go to the next book. It's like, okay. But I really enjoy the books, but it's like...
There's only so much you can retain.
Yeah, I mean, I have more important stuff in my head, like voices, you know?
Let's see, where was I? Dark92Enigma asks, if you have ever seen any fan works from the Brony fandom, such as fan-made episodes or shorts, comic dubs and animations, what was your favorite and which is your least favorite?
I don't have a least favorite. What kind of question is that? I have a lot of favorites. I mean, there's a lot of really cool art and songs and I can't really choose. And I know that if I'm gonna say names, I'm gonna forget some other names, and I just will feel guilty for not saying all the names. So I'm not gonna say that happened before. I'm like that, and that, and that, mm-hmm. And then I'm like, oh, why didn't I mention that and that? Because, or him, or him, or her, because like, oh, because people I met and stuff. I'm like, oh. So I will say that I have a lot of favorites. I have, yes.
Fair enough. I was gonna say, if you don't mention the people here in the chat who are watching you patiently, there will be probably a revolt of some sort.
Okay, thank Quasi. But she told me not to do that anymore, so I won't make shout outs to her. No, but she's good, so she deserves it. So then the others, let's see. Well, right now I can't see if you're ready. Oh well. Sorry if I forget someone.
Let's see. Venher asks, what's your favorite music? I'll break the question down a little bit more. How about favorite genre to listen to?
I'm a real harmony nerd, so I love when it's a lot of harmonies. And Well, I really like a good pop song with a nice piano and a lot of harmonies to it. That's what I like. So, but it really depends on mood.
Sure.
Because, as I said before, Barbie Girl is always nice when it's a party or just listen to Kesha or anything like that. Really poppy and really... But then sometimes I just want to listen to, like, late 70s singer-songwriters like Gilbert O'Sullivan. I do that too, so it depends on mood. But I'm kind of picky when it comes to music.
Really?
So, yes.
Nothing wrong with that.
No.
Let's see.
But I mean, I never go like, if I'm at a friend's house, I'm like, we can't listen to this. I would never do that. So it's just when it comes to when I'm sitting with my headphones. Like, I'm going to listen to this now. No, not this now. I mean, a really good song can be like, it's really good, but not now. And then I listen to it half an hour later. Like, oh, now it's good.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
How about... Okay, here's a good one. Magic Spark asks, what emotions do you pull from to create your voices?
Oh... Well, that's a very good question. What emotions do I... I mean, I'm so very there and then when I'm standing there. I'm very in the moment. So I just... I listen to the original and I see if I can make it really like the original. And then I both following... I follow the emotions that the original actress does, but I also try to make my own little thing with it. So I think that's the only question I can come up with at 12 in the middle of the night.
How about... Alicorn Texas Boy asks, if you can voice act for any other show... What show would it be and why?
Oh, it's also good. The only thing I can come up with right now, because my daughter watched it late today, is the Tinkerbell.
Sure.
It's the only, and I actually been in the Tinkerbell movie, the one who is premiered a couple of months ago here in Sweden with the pirate. I was the jumping sounds and the screams and the laughters from the pixies. Because it was like, I don't know why, but they called me in to do that.
Action.
But not all of it, just a little bit extra. So. But it would be nice to speak too in that in that show. So yes.
I bet. Let's see here. I already answered that one. Okay, here's one. Console asks, why do you think you are one of the most well-known European voice actresses in the fandom?
Well, I think I have to thank Spitfire for that. That clip when I said that thing. I think.
He also asks, is your comedian style, does that make you more comfortable to be in the open, like on Twitter?
I think so. I mean, I love making jokes and making people laugh and happy. I mean, I really like that, so... yeah, I guess.
What works, right?
I mean, as long as you have fun, that's a really important thing for me. I want to do things that's fun. But I mean, sure, I do things that's not fun too, like cleaning and stuff. But I really, when I go on Twitter, I just want to, you know, have fun and talk to people and just, you know, some silliness is never wrong. So, and I mean, I have so much silliness going on. I don't know where to put it, so I put it on Twitter. You have to bear with me. And if you don't like it, well. So if you like random silliness, you can follow me. And if you don't, you don't have to. So.
How could you hate good, clean fun like that?
Really? Yeah. Yeah.
Some people, I suppose. Whatever.
People.
There needs to be a shifty-eyed dog going on here.
Oh, really?
Mr. Ben asks, give us a typical rundown of your day as a voice actress.
Well, I come to the studio at around, let's say, just for fun, 9. And I do my thing until 12, and then it's lunch, and maybe I go to another studio across town. I don't know why. they're never close. And maybe I do a commercial for something, and then it takes like half an hour. And then I go to a third studio, and I do something else for maybe 2 hours. So I'm dubbing, and then I go home. It sounded so glamorous, didn't it? I forgot to mention my limo. No. Just kidding. I never actually sat in a limo. That's too bad. I should totally do that.
Yes.
Yes, I should do that. Someday.
Arrive in a limo at a pony convention.
That would be cool. Then I would be like, come in here, everyone. Let's go. Let's drive around town screaming, yoohoo!
I'm sure the random passerby would be going,
huh? That would be cool. A couple of cosplayers, ponies, like in the limo, like with their heads up, and that would be cool. And me, like, dancing. We could go around town, like Anneli Heed limo VIP pony party. It's gonna happen.
It's gonna happen.
It has to happen. Now, it is a reality.
Make it so, number one.
Yes. This is number one.
Let's see. Venher asks, what's your favorite game?
Game? Ooh. I don't play much. I guess it's computer games. I guess it is.
Not necessarily. You know, go whichever.
That's the only games I play, I think. But not so much anymore. I was playing a lot of Nintendo games growing up, like Super Mario and all of those. But not so much now, no. I did voice a couple of games. I did the Transformers Prime game and Cars 2 game. And what's the name of that one? Oh, I can't remember, but it was in English. Yeah.
So I guess I'll ask this as a follow-up.
Half-Life 2. Sorry. Expansion for Half-Life 2. That's important. And I was a Russian alien, and I was speaking like this. I had lots of fun recording that one.
You did that?
Yes, I did. It was an expansion.
Still, but... I gotta take a drink here. Okay.
And my tea is cold. Oh no. Of all the things that could possibly happen, my tea has gone cold. Oh. My life, oh my God, I tell you.
It's just one crisis after another, isn't it?
Yeah. I have a big cup of tea and it's, you know. So people will be listening to this on YouTube later, but okay, she was talking about spices, and then she was talking about that her tea went cold, and there was a limo in some, though. I don't know what she was... Yeah, the word yellow, she said something like, I don't know.
Only on BwB.
Oh, yeah.
Let's see. Matt the Shadow Man asks, hey, Anneli. How much input do you, as the voice actresses, have in the dub?
Well, not that much, but sometimes I would like it to be much, and they're not happy with me. No, but you know, if there's a joke in there, as a comedian, I just have to try to save the joke. If the translator hasn't got the joke, or if it's a very American reference. And it's possible to fix it, I always ask, please, can we do this? And if we have time, they'll let me do it. And, I mean, it's really important that the jokes are there, I think, especially if it's a very comedic show and character. Mm-hmm. So I'm always like, come on, is it okay if I say this instead? Is it okay if we change this? But just if it's really necessary, I ask them. And they're like, okay. Sometimes, no, sorry, no. And then, okay, sure, I tried. So
that leads to a follow-up question I have. Do things like American originating and predominant sayings, has interacting with various places helped bridge that gap?
I think so. Yeah. And the funny thing was that when I was going to New Orleans, 2 days before I was supposed to go there, I did a voice test for Monster High, a character named Honey Swamp. And she was from New Orleans. So she had these accents, you know? And she was talking about this and the big swamps. And I was so happy to hear that because I was like, oh, I'm going to go there in 2 days. Just speaking like the people are going to speak there. Woo! And then I came there and it was perfect. It was her all over. It was she really, people really talk that way. And I love that accent. So, and then I came home and I found out that I got the part. It was like, perfect. I did my research. I went to New Orleans to research this character. I promise you.
And that's what we like to call a big payoff.
Oh yeah, there's actually a little a clip in my showreel when I tried to get that New Orleansy feeling about her, and I think I did a pretty good job in the Swedish version too. That you can almost hear that she has something going on with the New Orleans accent, even though I can't put a New Orleans accent on Swedish because that would be, you know. But I really hope that I got the feel of her. I feel that I got the feel of her.
Good. As long as you walked away happy, that's...
I did. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. So it really depends.
Exactly.
Mostly I do. But, yeah.
Let's see here. Quasi asks, mm-hmm. Hello, Anneli. Are you preparing some kind of Christmas surprise for your fans, like the Ponylicious Christmas song last year?
Maybe... I have plans, yes, but there is a little something that I need to fix first. But I really hope that I can go through with it. I really hope so. I have intentions on doing a certain thing.
Wow. Cool. Look forward to it. Let's see. It's jumping ahead to need to... Oh, I know the one. Twilight is Magic asks, what has been the hardest piece of voice acting for you to do in your career thus far?
The hardest. I don't. Maybe. I mean, it wasn't. It wasn't a hard voice, but it was. It was kind of complicated because it was in the movie, the DreamWorks movie, Monsters versus Aliens. Mm-hmm. I'm the. You know, the evil guy. He is Galaxar, and he has a computer, and that's me. And it was really. The mic settings had to be really close because, I mean, it was for the big cinema theaters.
Right.
So it has to be real close. So, I mean, I couldn't even make a little extra sound or anything, just the very, 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 very pure sound of it because it was supposed to be in the really big systems. So that was kind of, you know, hard technically to really make that, I think. So I was, yeah. And I was really new to the dubbing scene. So I was kind of nervous too. So I was like, oh dear, it was the first time I was working with a director. And it was a really big movie. And I was kind of new in the game. So I was like, oh dear. It was kind of hard. But it was fun. Yes, I'm best computer.
Do you feel you pulled it off?
Yes. When I heard it, I was happy. So yes.
Excellent.
Excellent.
Good, my good old Mr. Burns impersonation.
But you had to do the thing with the fingers too when you say it. Excellent.
You don't think I do?
Perfect.
All right, we've got about 10 minutes left, so I'm really going to be jumping around questions here, trying to get some of those who haven't asked one yet. Mm-hmm. Ooh, here's a good one. Twistermon asks, have you received some good gifts from your Brony fans?
Oh, yes, I have. It's so, I get so surprised every time I get a gift. It's like, really, you did this for me? And I mean, I have I have saved, I mean, I really got really cute letters, wonderful letters that I even bought a box. I'm holding the box now. Can you hear the box?
Now we
with
can.
With the letters.
Yes.
Yeah. And it's with lots of flowers, purple flowers on it. And I really got to pick out this nice box to put them in because they're really valuable to me, these letters. And I got a crayon statue of Swayfire, my pony Sona. Pins and a really cool pinky hat with the sparkling. It's pink with pinky. And figurines and beautiful necklace from Silver Slinger. From Cutie Coral, this really big Spitfire plushie. And a golden rose, and a lot of beautiful things that it's really nice to have. I mean, whenever I have a rainy day, I just look at these and I'm like, oh, someone likes me. No, just kidding. But it's really nice. I mean, I really cherish these things.
I like that. I like to hear stuff like that. All right. Mr. Ben asks, what is love?
I was going to sing there. What is love? Why do you ask me? Well, I don't want to give a cheesy answer now, but... Oh, no, I can't say that because it sounds really cheesy to say that. But I have to, like, okay, so the pony fandom, there's a lot of love going on there. Towards the show and towards the friends, and you know, yeah, it sounds kind of cheesy, but it's true. There's a lot of love going on.
There is.
Mm-hmm.
He was waiting for the song, I think.
Yeah, I think so too. I just didn't want to say, "Baby, don't hurt me." I was like, "No, I don't want to." Now I did it anyway. So you got your wish. And then he got this serious answer.
Yes. She saw right through my clever ploy, he says.
Okay. Hey, remember that thing when I said yellow?
Yes.
The good times.
Good times, man. Good times. Man. All right, let's go to this next question. Yes. Venher asks, what's your favorite animal?
I want to say cat or dog, but I'm just going to say like the in-between, and that's a chihuahua. It's like, because I wanted a dog, and my husband is allergic to... No, I wanted a cat, but my husband is allergic to cats. So I got the closest thing, and it was a chihuahua. So I used to have a chihuahua, but not anymore. But that's a really favorite animal because they are crazy. They just sit around and shiver all the time and they look super cute. It's like, why are you shivering? Why are you shivering? And they have to do things. That's why they're shivering. Like, ooh, I have to go outside for a while. Or, ooh, I'm happy. Or, ooh, I'm afraid. Or, ooh, I have to eat. Or, ooh, I'm just a chihuahua.
I don't care what he says. I'm freezing.
Yeah, something like that. So that's my favorite animal, I think. But I mean, I wouldn't like to be a chihuahua because all that shivering, I don't know. I'm not that shivery of a person. I would like to fly. That would be cool. Nice. Like a cat, but a flying cat. A purple flying cat. Yeah. Well, that would be cool.
Please don't tell me you'd have one horn and one eye.
No. No? What's that?
A one-eyed, one-horn flying purple people eater, of course.
Oh, I never heard about that. Say it again. Oh, you pass.
A one-eyed, one-horn, flying purple people eater. Look
but
it
I
up.
Said faster.
One-eyed, one-horn, flying purple people eater. One-eyed, one-horn, flying purple people eater. That's about as good as I'm going to get.
Well.
All right. We're going to close the audience questions down. We have time for about one more here. Mm-hmm. And I just have to ask, two of them, I'm sorry. There is one more from Mr. Ben. Mm-hmm. Where is it? He asks, would you be interested in perhaps coming back on for a second interview sometime in the future?
Here?
Yeah.
Nah. Of course. Of course.
Ow, my heart.
Like, nah. Ooh, someone posted pictures from Galacon. Ooh, I haven't seen this before. Oh, it looks so happy. I look like, there is not two cosplayer plushies behind me. No, there's not. You're kidding me. I'm not going to look a second time. That's what I'm thinking now. They're like, ah. Ooh, yeah.
I do have one more question for you. Mm-hmm. What are your... Go ahead.
Sorry. The other picture is me and Julie. And she is from the French. From the French. She is a French rarity. So she's speaking like this, almost. And she's lovely. Aw, I want to say hi to Julie. Ah, Julie. I love calling her Julie. I mean, her name is Julie, but she's French, so we have to say Julie. I'm like, I'm going to call my friend Julie. And she answers to it, so.
I know.
Perfect. Okay, so sorry, what was the question?
No. What are your future plans, both in Pony and not in Pony?
In Pony, mm-hmm. Just keep on voicing, and just keep on with the hanging out on Twitter, I guess, and hopefully going to a lot of conventions. Gonna go to Holland. That's gonna be fun. Heartwarming Eve convention.
Nice.
So yes.
How about not non-Pony related things?
Oh. Just taking over the world, stuff like that.
Yeah. Of course.
Of course. I mean, he doesn't want to do that. No, but, well, it's nothing I can talk about right now, but there is some funny things going on. And I will continue with my radio shows that I'm on. I'm on two radio shows.
Nice.
And, yes, that's funny. So I do that, and maybe something else. I can't tell you yet.
I understand.
Yes.
There is, let's see. I guess I could ask this. Would you be interested? Mm-hmm. 10 years, or I shouldn't say 10 years. Say the show, MLP in particular, is what I'm referring to. Mm-hmm. The show's over. It's 10 years since that time. What is the one thing you are going to take the most from this?
Oh, well, it will not be the show per se. It will be more of the Brony fandom, I think. I will remember the most because, all of the great memories from the conventions. I will always carry them with me. So, I mean, the show, of course, but this is bigger than the show for me. It is, yeah. Just to meet all of you guys.
That is a nice answer. I like that. I like it. I like asking that to others, but anyway. Otherwise, that is all we have for today, folks.
Yes.
Unless.
Well, do I have something to say? I don't know. Like, if you want to, like, say hi or something, just go on Twitter and say hi. I'm Anneli Heed there, and I have a Facebook fan page. It's called Anneli Heed, voice actor. And yeah, that's, oh yeah.
Don't be afraid.
I always forget to mention these things. So now I remember to do this. It's good to do that. So just to say hi. You want to say hi.
What's wrong with just saying hi?
And now someone writes in big letters, corn.
Trust me, that's the randomness we get. Hear it. You should see what happens when people irritate me. Let's just put it this way. The windows haven't survived. But anyway, enough about me. One thing I do want to ask you is, want to plug your website?
Oh, yeah, sure. It's www.annelieheed.com. It's AnneliHeed.
The only voice you'll need.
Oh, yeah, Anneli Heed. The only voice you'll need. I say that in my Spitfire voice. I'm so surprised that no one asked me about saying things in Spitfire voice.
As a matter of fact, as am I. Do you want to rectify that?
I don't know. You want to hear it?
Only if you wish, Ms. Heed.
If I wish? He's like, please ask me.
Very well.
No. No, it's okay. I will save it for another time.
Makes it all the more... what's the word I'm looking for? It'll make the wait worth it. That's what I'm trying to say.
Yes. I think I said it before, so people will find it. If you will search for it, you will find me name that pastry. You're like, well, welcome to Name This Pastry.
With Anneli Heed.
Yes. That would be fun. Have like a Twitter game going on. Name this pastry.
Or a Jeopardy question. Have it as a Jeopardy question.
Yeah, it sounds like a typical Jeopardy category.
An apple pie.
So for 800, we have named this. Yeah.
I was going to say, Alex Rebecca is on there. We have a pony named Soren ate this food. What
during
was it?
The gala.
During the gala. What was it?
During the gala, the pony named Soren had this for dessert. And then it's like, what is apple pie, Alex?
Correct.
Yay!
Whose pastry is this anyway?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, good lord.
The other thing, what is Pinkie Pie's favorite cookie? And says, like, cupcakes!
Good delivery.
You didn't form it as a question. You're out of the game. No! And
yet Jeopardy you just know that somehow Pinky would win Jeopardy.
Yeah, just by like punching others' buttons just to get to win and stuff. And then she would win something really lame and she would be like, come on!
What can I do with this?
He's like, what? I don't know how to use this! My pinky is not that good. I'm going to stick to Rarity Fluttershy, I think. I don't know what to do with this. Is it a bicycle on a pony? I can't use it.
And you just know she'd be comforted right there.
Yeah.
Not that that's a bad thing. I'm just saying.
No, it's never a bad thing. They were like, it's okay. Like, oh yeah, that was I can't do the Twilight voice. He's like, I'm gonna try it. He's like, it's okay, Fluttershy.
That's not bad.
Thanks. That's
bad
all.
At all.
Thank you. I have to practice on that one, I guess.
All right. Oh. Anything before we go, Ms. Heed?
No, I don't know. No, I don't know. So, no. I'm gonna come up with a lot of things after. Like, oh, why didn't I say this or something? But, you know, there's always a next time.
Isn't it always, though? You know, you get done and it's, why didn't I do this? Why didn't I do that?
Yeah.
Ugh, I hate that so much.
It's gonna happen, so. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But no, for now, I think I'm happy. Yes. I hope you are, too.
I'll say that for later. But in the meantime, folks, thank you for stopping by. Hope you stick around next time, or not only next episode, but stick around. There's more to come from Twilight is Magic.
And the next time, it's going to be the Dalmatian episode, because it's going to be 101.
Yes, it is. I never thought of
it's the Dalmatian episode. And this is the 100th episode. It's the pony episode? Nah.
Now I almost feel like I need to review 101 Dalmatians on our show next episode. Maybe I will. I'll think about it. What I can say is originally planned, we're going to be reviewing season 2, episode 24 next week. That is Mystery on the Friendship Express. So,
the cake.
The cake got eaten.
Yes. See how I know this? I'm very proud.
Nothing wrong with that.
No, I know this, and yes, I'm proud of it.
So yes, for everyone, if you want to join in on our style of looking at episodes and reviewing them, stop on by next week, same time, same place. In the meantime, I want to thank everyone for stopping on by on behalf of Twilight is Magic and Mr. Ben. We want to thank everyone for stopping by, and of course, Ms. Heed.
Thank you for inviting me. I had fun.
Thank you. I like to hear that. Thank you. In the meantime, we will see everyone later. Until then, farewell.
Farewell.